Hey, what's going on, guys? Sean here, living the corporate pilot life. It is Tuesday, so yeah, I got a Tech Tuesday video for you guys on something I've been asked a little bit about here lately. And in honor of you guys up in the north, still getting some cold weather, I thought we would talk a little bit about ice. And most importantly, the ice protection system on the Hawker aircraft. The Hawker uses a TKS system, which stands for Tkalimit Kilfrost Sheepridge Stokes. Yes, I looked it up right before I recorded this to make sure I got it right. Nobody uses that, it's just TKS. TKS was developed way back in like World War II era times to prevent ice from getting on airplanes, and it works really well. It's basically a glycol-based solution that gets pushed out through the leading edge of the wings, and it runs back along the wings, and it keeps ice from building up on them. So let me show you a few things about how the system works and how the fluid runs through the system. So let me show you over here on the wing first, and we'll go inside the cockpit and show you how we operate it. All right, so on the leading edge of the wings, you notice it kind of looks like it's shiny or sparkly, if you will. Those are tiny little holes that are laser etched into that leading edge to force that fluid out through those holes. Like I said, they're tiny little holes, and essentially the fluid comes out and it runs back along the top of the wing and the bottom, and it prevents any ice from building up on the surface. Ice on the surface is a really bad thing. Even a small amount of ice or even frost can really affect how the airplane flies. So we want to make sure we keep the ice off the airplane pretty much at all cost. So let's go up front and I'll show you a little more about it. All right, while we're on the outside of the airplane here, let's take a quick look. This is our ice detector, this little probe right here. This little center thing, it spins, and as it spins, if it builds up any ice on here, it'll feel the resistance on this little triangle blade on the back, and it'll detect it, and it'll tell us in the cockpit that, hey, you've got ice on the airplane. And at that point, it's a little too late to even start doing stuff, but we'll still do it anyway. Hopefully, we're ahead of the game at that point, and I've already turned on some anti-ice systems, but let's go up in the cockpit, and I'll show you how we do that. On our way into the airplane, if you notice, we got a little panel right here that says TKS filler tube. If we open that guy up, you'll see it's just a pretty simple little funnel system to put the TKS fluid in. The early Hawkers had it under the pilot seat, which was a real pain to fill it, so they put in a convenient little spot right here to put that stuff into. It's really nasty, sticky, gross, corrosive stuff, so we try and keep that stuff off our hands as much as possible. So this makes it a little bit easier to get it into the system. Holds a couple gallons of that fluid, so we can keep it pumped up. Way over here on the right, you'll see a little gauge. It shows empty right now, but that's because the battery's off. If I turn the battery on, you'll notice we got almost a full tank. Not quite a full tank, so we may have to top that thing off before we go anywhere. I'm gonna turn that back off. All right, there we go. All right, up here on the overhead panel now, you'll see a little knob there that says wing tail anti-ice. That's how we turn on the system. So if we reach up here and we just twist it, it just starts a little timer and it starts running the fluid out onto the wings. Obviously nothing's happening right now because I got the battery power turned off, but if I had the batteries and everything powered up, we would be spitting fluid out onto the wings. So right now I'm just going to turn it back and we'll turn it off. There we go. If the batteries were on, we would hear a loud ding when I turned it off. But that's how we operate the system. When we're coming in towards clouds, we'll turn that on, start pumping some fluid out onto the wings, get some nice protection out there. And then once we get into the clouds, if we get any ice, it's not gonna adhere to the wings. It's just gonna run right off basically. And then when we come out of the clouds, we'll turn that off and save the fluid. So that's how it works. If you notice there's a switch down here, it says engine anti-ice. Those switches operate the engine cowl anti-ice, and that's operated through hot air being pumped out onto the cowling to keep any ice from building up on those surfaces. But the wings and the tail, like I said, those got the anti-ice fluid, the TKS, and that keeps us from getting any ice on the airplane. So that's a nutshell of how the TKS system works. It's pretty simple, works really well. It's a very easy to operate system. You just turn the little knob on and it pumps some fluid out there, and it keeps the ice from getting on the wings. So yeah, it's a very important system. Wings with ice on them don't fly very well. So we definitely wanna make sure we're using that anytime we're getting into ice. For me, if I'm getting into some really heavy icing, I'm gonna get out of it, even with the TKS or a hot wing. I wanna get out of that ice as quickly as I can. It's very bad to be in those situations. And luckily, with the technology now, we figured out that ice is pretty localized. If you get into ice, you can pretty much change altitude. You know, 5,000 feet will typically get you out of it. So you climb or descend and you can get yourself out. And for the altitudes that we fly out and cruise up high, we're not gonna get any ice anyway. This is really only in the climb and the descent for us that we're gonna really see this stuff. So we're gonna get above it or we're gonna get down below it as quickly as we can. So hopefully you guys learned a little something about how we operate the anti-ice TKS system on the Hawker. Give me the thumbs up if you liked it, subscribe if you're new, and we'll see you on the next Tech Tuesday. See ya.